Shut up and sit down.
Hey, I'm Simon.
I'm Nicolas Cage.
Hey, Nicolas Cage. Well, we are having a couple of drinks that are called...
Manatee Christmas.
Manatee Christmas. Nice.
I will not be accepting any questions at this time.
Okay, fine. No further questions. And if you like our silly videos, please remember to like, comment, and most of all, subscribe. And we're watching movie trailers tonight that the other person has not yet seen, and surprising them, no. And filming our silly reactions.
So what trailer do we have next? And it better not have Nicolas Cage in it, because I'm going to cry.
Well, this one does absolutely not have Nicolas Cage in.
Thank goodness.
This is another trailer for a movie that comes out in 2021. There's no release date for it yet. It's coming to Netflix, and it is Netflix's first ever foray into the anime movie market. Featuring talent who worked on Fullmetal Alchemist, on Cowboy Bebop, and such other fantastic anime movies. And I'm really, really intrigued. I saw the thumbnail for it. It looked a lot like Studio Ghibli, but it is not Studio Ghibli, but it looks very much like it.
That sounds promising.
Yeah, so let's check out the trailer. That's not nice.
The humans are dead.
Mama, Papa.
これは人間。サラ。
サラ。サラ。
人間がここにいることを知られてはいけない。ここの外にいる多くのロボットたちは。人間のことを悪い存在だと思っている。
もうエデン3にはいられない。
ずっと思ってたの。
サラ！
なんで私はここにいるんだろうって。どうして私は人間なんだろう。なんでロボットじゃないの？
サラ。
サラ。
So, we have just seen the trailer, and that was just a teaser for the new anime, Eden, coming to Netflix, apparently in May 2021, although there's no firm release date at this point. What did you think?
It looks very cute.
Yeah.
Very anime. I wasn't expecting it to be so kind of well done. I think Netflix can sometimes be a bit clumsy, but I thought it was really well done, and it just looked kind of cute, and those robots, I like it.
Cool. I love the fact, so it's set in a place called Eden 3, where they believe the humans have gone extinct, but clearly not all of them, that somehow they found someone called Sara, who is alive, but is raised by robots, which I thought was kind of a cool twist. We've seen Mowgli raised by animals. I thought that was a cool twist, that she doesn't know if she fits in being a human living in the robot world. That was kind of cool. I thought the animation in it was awesome as well.
Like, really classic as
yeah,
well.
Exactly. Looks like real classic anime. And it's what do you think about dubbed versus subbed?
I am the worst, so I like dubbed.
Ooh.
I just want people to speak to me. I don't like subtitles.
Yeah, and so I've got to say, I was of the same mind. Like, I would always buy anime and manga in dubbed versions because I was just lazy and I didn't want to read. Like, I don't want homework when I'm watching a movie or a TV show. But when we went to see Spirited Away, and you were hosting it wearing a very fancy Spirited Away dress, and we had soot sprites, and yeah, it was very cool. I was actually really impressed with just how much more immersive it was watching it subtitled.
Yeah, there is definitely, you kind of get a slightly different feel for it when you hear the Japanese. And I feel like once you, like, because we're not used to reading subtitles, but you kind of slide into it really easily, and then you kind of, you don't necessarily notice that you're reading, you just kind of go along with it. But I still like dubbed versions. I'm sorry, I know it's horrific and I'm probably missing out on so much, but I don't care, I just like dubbed versions.
Yeah, and actually, I mean, when the quality of the voice actors for dubbed versions is so high now, like, I get it that originally, like, I remember watching, I think the first Ghost in the Shell manga movie, I remember watching Akira, and some of the voice acting was pretty poor. And yeah, it was a better experience watching the subtitled version. I think these days it's a different game and the quality of the voice acting is so much higher.
Maybe that's why people are still kind of feel really strongly about not liking dubbed versions. Maybe they were just like burned early on.
Yeah.
Whereas, like you said, I mean, it attracts incredible talent now. Now, like, anime is more established and kind of more mainstream. It attract, like, it attracts incredible talent. So maybe part of it is just that there wasn't good enough voice actors previously, and now there are.
Yeah. Yeah, and I would be amazed if a dubbed version doesn't come out at some point. I mean, knowing the Western audience that Netflix has, I think they would be silly not to release a dubbed version at first. You know, maybe do the subtitled version at first and then follow it up with a dubbed version in a few months or something and just reach a new demographic who missed it the first time around. But aside from that, I've got to say, you know, the story looks really compelling. The animation looks amazing. Like, the background art, like that big mirrored cube.
Yes.
Yeah, it just looks really different. Like, we've seen so much sci-fi stuff that seems samey. And even, like, the Wall-E kind of a world where you've got, you know, this kind of dystopian future. The world's full of garbage because people suck. I like it that, I mean, maybe people did suck and that's why they're extinct. But I like it that robots kind of clean the place up.
They seem to be friendly robots.
Yeah, they do. They're not, yeah. Yeah, exactly. I like that a lot.
Yeah, it's nicely optimistic.
Yeah, well, I think that's four big old thumbs up from the Nerd Safari crew.
Two of them are mine.
Yeah, two of them are mine, but one's behind a manatee Christmas. And yeah, I think we're pretty excited about Eden. It looks like a great time. I'm really intrigued to see. I hope it does come out in May.
Yeah.
We've got one person who will be turning 17 in our household in May who would quite like it. Well, friends, we will see you, not in May 2021, but just tomorrow, because we do this every single day because we love you guys. And we will see you on the next Drunk Trailer Ambush.
Peace out, nerds.
Bye.
Shut up and sit down.